Dear student, hello. I am Dr. Sanjay Pagar, Associate Professor, Department of Geography. Dear student, I welcome all of you in this online lecture series on behalf of Maratha Vidya Prasarak Samajas, KRT Arts, BS Commerce and AM Science, popularly known as KTHM College Nashik. Dear student, today in this SYBSS class, semester 3rd, Geography paper 1st, that is environmental geography, we are going to discuss very important subtopic of our first chapter. The title of the chapter is Introduction to Environment Geography, and subtopic that we are going to discuss today is definition and the concept of ecosystem. Today we have a lecture number 8. Dear student, ecosystem is one of the most important topic from our syllabus. This topic not only important for our subject but also carries weightage in the various competitive exam as well as in the other subject. Dear student, in previous lecture we have discussed the basic information about the environment. Before starting with our today's topic, let us revise what we had seen in our previous lecture. First thing we was discussed in the last lecture, that was the meaning of environment. You know that, student, the term environment has been derived from the French word, that is envir. It means surrounding totality. It means also round about. Environment means the sum of total condition which surrounded man at a given point in a space and time. Then we also discuss the definition of environment. Environment means surrounding in which organism live. We also discuss the type of environment. Especially on the basis of various criteria, we have discussed the various subtype of the environment. The criteria such as structure or creation. Then we have the biological condition or the physical state. On the basis of these criteria, we have discussed the subtype of the environment. Especially, we have two major type of the environment, that is natural environment and the man-made environment. Detailed information about all this subtopic we have already discussed in our previous lecture. Dear student, for this today's lecture we have a study objective or learning objective, that is very simple, to discuss definition and the concept of ecosystem. So let us start the discuss the information about the concept, that is ecosystem. You know that, student, A.G. Tansley was an English botanist. He was the professor of the botany at the University of the Oxford. It is a very famous university in the world. He worked in this university as a professor near about 10 years. From 1927 to 1937, during this 10 years period, he worked very important research on the ecosystem. During this research work, he published very important article, and title of that article was The Use and Abuse of Vegetation Term and the Concept. In 1935, the first time he introduced or the proposed the concept of ecosystem. In this concept, he given very scientific and basic information of ecosystem. You know that, student, the ecosystem is a word. It's a combination of the two words, that is eco and system. Eco means related to the environment, whereas system means interacting group. It's a combination of the two major things, that are the abiotic factor and the biotic factor. And also you can say that the non-living factor and the living factor. Ecosystem means the ecological system. An ecosystem is an integrated part which consists interaction of plants, animals, birds and microorganisms. The function of every ecosystem involves the series of cycle. It like a water cycle, oxygen cycle, nitrogen cycle, carbon dioxide cycle and various cycles. In this diagram, I would like to show you the very important component that are the part of the ecosystem. The ecosystem component and their interrelationships form the structure and the function of the ecosystem. Especially, sun play very important role in ecosystem. Then plant, atmosphere, various consumer, a microorganism, and the part of the natural environment that are the soil, water, nutrient, mineral, and so many things. Dear student, you know that the sun helps plant to produce their own food by the process of photosynthesis. The photosynthesis is a process during which the plant make their own food in the presence of the sunlight and the chlorophyll. It's a process in which all the green plants convert light energy into the chemical energy. And the sun energy allows the plants to convert inorganic chemical into the organic components. We have the atmosphere. The atmosphere also very important. There is a mutual relationship between the atmosphere and the plants, because atmosphere provide carbon dioxide to plants, and whereas the plants release the oxygen, which is helped to maintain the ecological balance of the environment. The oxygen is also useful for the survival of all the various biotic organisms that are present on the surface. Then we have the consumer. The consumers also play very important role in ecosystem. Especially, I am talking about the function of the ecosystem. We have the different type of the consumers, like a primary consumer, secondary consumer, tertiary consumers. Then we have the soil. I just mentioned that soil, water, nutrient. Because plants require soil, plants require water and nutrient for their growth. Without growth, plants can't make their own foods. And very important thing that the plants provide the foods for other organisms also that are present on the surface. I just mentioned like a consumers, all birds, animal and microorganism get their food from the plants. So this is about the components of ecosystem. So dear student, let us see the definition of the ecosystem. A complex relationship between all living and non-living things interact with each other, known as ecosystem. In this definition, two things are very important. First thing, there is a relationship, and second thing, relationship between the living and non-living components, or the living components also known as the biotic components, whereas non-living components also known as the abiotic components. And you observe there is a continuous relationship between two factors, and that are the mentioned in the first definition. Second definition, an ecosystem is a geographic area where plants, animal and the other organisms, as well as weather and the landscape, work together to form a life on the earth's surface. Dear student, in this concept, here also same thing we have repeated. The first thing, that there is a interrelationship between living and non-living factor, or you can say biotic factor, such as plants, animal and the other organism, and the abiotic factor that are the here in this definition specially mentioned, weather, it means the climate and the landscape. Now they work together to form a life on the surface. Let us discuss the definition that are given by various scholars or the botanists. Naturally, the first definition that was given by the A.G. Tansley, he stated ecosystem as it is of any special unit of nature where living substance interact to produce an action of material between the living and the non-living component. This was the first definition that was explained by the A.G. Tansley in 1935. Then we have the second definition that are given by the A.M. Woodbury, the American ecologist. He stated ecosystem in 1954. Ecosystem is a complex in which habitat, plants and animals are considered as one interesting unit. The materials and energy of one passing in and out of the others. In this definition, again I would like to explain the few terms. The first term that is very important, that is habitat. A habitat, a place or the environment where plants, animal, natural lives or grow, like a forest, like a desert, or maybe the other part of the earth where the, all the living things are, living organism are live. And in this definition, again, the second thing is very important. There is a relationship between the biotic and the abiotic factor. So these are also mentioned by the Woodbury in this definition. Then we have the definition, next definition that is given by or explained by the A.P. Odom, the American biologist. He stated ecosystem in 1971. According to him, ecosystem as the basic fundamental unit of ecology, which includes both the organism and the non-living environment, each influencing the properties of the other, and each is necessary for the maintenance of the life. Student, you might be observed that here in this definition, he also explained same thing, that there is a interrelationship between the living and the non-living factor, and the both factor influencing each other, or each influencing the properties of the other, and each is necessary for the maintenance the life on the surface. That was explained, or that was the mentioned specially this Odom in his definition. Then we have next definition, very important definition that are given by E.F.R. Hosberg. He was also American botanist. He explained the term ecosystem in 1963. According to him, it is the functioning interacting system composed of one or more living organism and the effective environment, both physical and biological environment. In this definition, Hosberg specially give emphasis on the effective environment. He specially mentioned the physical environment. It may be the climate, it may be the topography, or it may be the forest, or it may be the other things, and also the biological environment. So here also in this definition also, interacting word is very important. Interacting system means here also he mentioned that there is a relationship between the living factor and the non-living factor. Especially here he mentioned in this definition living organism. This word he used for the biotic factor, whereas effective environment, both of physical and the biological, this word he used for the abiotic factor. So this is about the definition that are given by the various. Dear student, if you observe, if you read carefully all the definition, definition of ecosystem may have difference among the authors, but generally all have three common property that include, first is presence of biotic component, like plants, animals, birds, and microorganisms. And second thing that are here are some picture of this. They represent the biotic component. Then second, we have presence of abiotic component. We already discussed in last slide about the abiotic component. It may be the water, soil, rock, mineral, sunlight, climate, or anything, that all are the part of the physical environment. They are also present in the ecosystem. The last but not the least, their interaction, their interrelationship, because the function of the ecosystem or the structure of the ecosystem form from these two factors, that the biotic component and abiotic component. So therefore, in each and every ecosystem, or the definition of the ecosystem and the information of the ecosystem, you will across these three things. I repeat again, the presence of biotic component, presence of abiotic component, and last but not the least, their interaction, the interrelationship between the biotic and abiotic factor. Dear student, this was about today's lecture. In next lecture, we are going to discuss a very important part of this chapter, that is structure of ecosystem. So, okay, thank you.